According to the National Organization of Spanish Blind People, 80% of the information necessary for our daily activities involves the eyes. Shopping is a big problem for visually impaired people, especially in large self-service supermarkets. Not only must they know how to guide themselves and detect obstacles, but also locate products and differentiate them from each other. Traditional methods, such as the white cane or the guide dog, are not very effective in this environment. Accessible labeling, such as the Braille system, is not mandatory for food products in Spain, which makes the identification more challenging. The aim of the project is to create an embedded system located in a shopping cart, which assists visually impaired people with shop navigation, product localization, and obstacle avoidance. The first step is to create a map of the supermarket. We use a LiDAR located in the bottom part of the shopping cart to detect the distance to the obstacles. We use SLAM algorithms to simultaneously create a map and do localization. Moving the shopping cart through the different corridors of the store updates the map and increases the accuracy. This example shows the mapping of a small house, but this procedure would be accomplished in a similar way in a supermarket. When the map is completed, we need to detect all the products from the shelves. One possible way to accomplish this could be training a computer vision model to detect all the products by the appearance of the packaging. But we rejected the idea due to the larger size of the model to be loaded into the camera. Then we decided to use two different approaches. The first approach is a manual detection method by scanning the barcode of every product and storing the position of the label in 3D. An employee of the supermarket scans every type of product on the shelves, and the camera captures the position of the hand with respect to the origin of the map previously created. The ID of the product and its position is stored in a database. The employee can scan the barcode from the label on the shelf or directly from the product. There is no need to scan every product, just one per type, because all the same products are located in the same place on the shelves, and we know the amount of products available by consulting the inventory database of the store. The second approach is an automatic detection by reading the name of the product in the label. We use a text detection model to find names in the images, and then we apply optical character recognition to convert it into text. The result is searched in the Open Food Fact database, and if there are any matches, the ID of the product is retrieved. Then, using the depth image from the camera, we obtain the 3D position of the label and store it in the database. With the map created and all products localized, the device is ready to be used by visually impaired people. In this example, we loaded a bunch of products in a random location, simulating the shelf from a real environment. To use the shopping cart, the user wears bone conduction headphones to communicate with the system using speech recognition and a text-to-speech interface.
What do you want to search?
Cereal.
Searching cereal. I've found 28 products. Honey Nut Cheerios, General Mills 306 grams to 12 meters. Do you want to go to the product?
No.
The user is able to search for something generic or be specific and find a product by saying its name and brand. A more refined search gives a faster result, but it's also possible to find products by their category or ingredients. For example, simply saying drinks or milk.
Corn flakes, Kellogg's 28 grams to 8 meters. Do you want to go to the product?
Yes.
Navigation started.
When the navigation starts, the shopping cart can autonomously navigate to the product position, or assist the user with sound commands to reach the product. It plays a sound in the right ear, or in the left ear, depending on the direction that the shopping cart has to turn. The device also detects obstacles and tells to the user through active feedback in the handle using vibration motors. The user will feel more vibration in the right or left hand depending on the direction of the obstacle, and also increasing the frequency if the obstacle approaches. Along with the LiDAR, we use the depth image from the OBD camera to create a point cloud from the front of the shopping cart, detecting obstacles that the LiDAR, due to its planar limitations, could miss. The navigation system takes the point cloud to a spatio-temporal voxel layer, which is used by the global planner to create a more precise cost map. When the shopping cart reaches the destination, it's time for the user to take the desired product from the shelf. We could use simple commands such as go up or go right to assist the user to find the product, but we realized that this way of guiding is so time demanding and it could cause frustration to the user. For this task, we have developed what we call oral augmented reality. Augmented reality is most often described as a digital visual overlay on physical reality. For visually impaired people, this visual representation could not be perceived, so we use an oral overlay instead. We place virtual 3D sounds in the environment that the user can perceive, using their bone conduction headphones to feel the position of the objects. To accomplish that, we use a head-related transfer function which represents how humans perceive real sounds from the world, and simulate 3D virtual sounds using stereo headphones. To get the user to the desired product on the shelf, we simulate that the product is playing a sound, in which the frequency increases when the hand approaches. Using the oral augmented reality guidance, the user can feel the position and the distance to the object and they are able to take it. The oral augmented reality needs the location of the product, the position of the hand, and the orientation and position of the head. We use the position of the product storing the data pills while creating the map. The head and the hand are detected by using the camera. To detect the position of the hand, we use a palm detection model along with the depth image to obtain the 3D position. For the head, we use a face detection model for the position, and face landmarks and head pose models to extract the orientation. This data is loaded in OpenCV library to simulate the 3D sounds using the head-related transfer function. Due to the field of view of the camera, there were situations when it was not able to track the user correctly. To avoid it, we have mounted the camera into a pan and tilt base, which allows it to freely move 360 degrees horizontally and 180 degrees vertically. Firstly, we try to use a PTC base used for security cameras, connecting it to a computer via PEL-CODI protocol. But we quickly discarded the idea due to the speed limitation and a poor control of its position. We decided to create our own pan and tilt base, based on an existing design. We created some parts to mount the camera to the base and to the aluminum profile. The parts were 3D printed in ABS and assembled with two stepper motors and bearings. The base is connected to the system by the GPIO pins from a Jetson Nano. The main purpose of the base is to track the head of the user in the center of the image, to be able to track it even if it's far away from the home position. When the shopping cart reaches its destination, the camera goes to the backwards position and starts tracking the head of the user. The pan and tilt base continuously tries to maintain the head in the center of the frame, while the oral augmented reality is active. When the product is taken, the pan and tilt base moves the camera to the forward position, to be prepared to go to the next product and help the obstacle avoidance system. Although some parts of the system are private, most of the code that involves computer vision is available in our GitHub repository. We have ported some code to create examples that you can run without additional hardware, only an OBD. The first demo shows how the pan and tilt base tracks the head trying to keep it centered in the frame. The second demo shows a 3D model representation of the head with its orientation and the location of the hand. The pan and tilt base can be moved to different positions using two sliders. The third demo shows how the oral augmented reality guidance works. There is a product in the virtual environment that can be moved freely in the 3D space. The camera detects the pose of our head and the position of our hand. When we move the head, we can feel in our headphones how the sound changes according to the virtual environment. and when we approach our hand to the product, the frequency of the sound increases. The last demo showed how the automatic product detection works, recognizing the name written in the labels and placing its position in the 3D world. We want to make supermarkets a more accessible place for visually impaired people. If you like the project, don't forget to support it and give us feedback to improve it. More information is available in our GitHub repository.